100 years ago, we educated children rather differently. There was chalk, corporal punishment, and lots of rote learning.
In Hawke's Bay, there's a boys' school that's looking to change another century-old tradition. They're opening the gates to girls. Here's Lucas de Jong.
It's home to 100 years of history, a century of tradition and learning, and 100 years of boys. But times are changing.
The rise of diversity, the rise of understanding and tolerance and patience, and respect and kindness.
Now, for the first time in almost 100 years, Hereworth School, the Hawke's Bay's private junior boys' school, wants to welcome in the girls.
To be able to work with them, to form relationships with them, and to prepare them for life.
We have had a lot of demand from grandparents, particularly, and from old boys who would like to educate their girls in the school.
What's the chat out there in the playground when you guys all heard? What were the boys saying?
I was like, yeah, I'm going to get a girlfriend now. All the boys are saying that.
Mika's been down the co-ed road before.
The girls are quite bossy there. Like, that's most girls. And then most of the girls were smarter than the boys.
Bossier and smarter.
Yeah.
So here you boys look smarter because you're the smartest in the school.
So if girls came, they would probably be showing us up.
Yeah. When's the last time you had a chat to a girl?
My sister this morning.
Oh, and it went all right?
Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah?
Boys would, like, learn how to act around girls. They wouldn't be so shy.
Yeah.
High school and stuff.
Well, we will have to look carefully at the curriculum programs that we are implementing within the school. We'll have to widen our breadth of co-curricular offerings with sports for girls.
Zara's ready. What do you think of this school? Oh, thumbs up!
She thinks she's part of the classroom already, as you can probably tell. She's always said since Louise started, I wish I could go to Hereworth, wish I could go to Hereworth.
It's a feeling that Mum knows all too well, because her brother once went here.
He was lucky enough to be sent off to this beautiful school while I was stuck in rural South Hawke's Bay. I sort of wanted to be part of the crew as well, but couldn't.
This school isn't alone.
The UK has decreased the number of single-sex schools by about 33%. If you look at what is happening across the globe, you will see that co-education is becoming a more common form of schooling. But I think when you look at what is the world of today, it is boys and girls together.
Modern life means costs, logistics and sibling relationships are pushing people towards co-ed schools.
We've already got 85 girls on our waiting list.
The plan here would be to increase the roll from 200 to 350, and in turn, cut tuition fees by half. They're just waiting for final approval from the ministry.
We haven't actually been told that we can have girls coming to the school yet, but we are planning that that will occur, and hopefully that will be from the start of 2023.
Oh, there are some old boys who would prefer us to remain as a boys-only school. But we have determined that this is the next 100 years. The excitement of the next 100 years is what we have to look towards rather than looking backwards.
Yeah, I went to a co-ed school and I went to a single-sex school as well. I always did better at the co-ed schools myself.
That doesn't surprise me. Not at all.